You are listening to the Hiking Radio Network, where we talk the walk with shows by hikers about hikers for everybody.
Welcome to the Trail Dames podcast, where we speak with women who love to dance upon this earth. So today you found another one of our Trail Dames podcast Lanyap episodes. And these are episodes where hopefully we educate you a little bit, just talk about something, maybe inspire and motivate you, share a couple of little stories. And today we're going to talk about campground etiquette. Now, I will not lie to you. This is going to be a little funny because my camping experience in terms of campgrounds all comes from the 70s, maybe a little bit early 80s. But since then, you can count the number of evenings I've spent at an actual campground on one hand. My life went more the backpacking route. But I have friends that have made camping an art. So I thought that we would talk about campground etiquette. So that's what we're going to do today on our Lanyap episode. Sit back and let's figure out what to do when you're ready to hit that KOA. My name is Anna Huthmaker. All my friends call me Mudbutt. And thank you for joining us for today's Lanyap episode of the Trail Dames podcast. I'm gonna dance upon this earth. Okay, so like I told you in the intro, my personal camping experience is pretty old-fashioned. And when I started doing research for this, that was kind of one of the first things I noticed. And I got to giggling because there's a lot of different rules than we used to have. But there are some that are universal and have no expiration date. I want to talk about those today. So some of the listeners, some of you guys have never been camping before, and maybe the idea of going to a campground is just feels more comfortable than the idea of hauling your stuff 2 miles down a trail with a backpack by yourself in the middle of nowhere. And I got to tell you, I totally get that. I 100% get that. And camping is a great place to start. And if you're going by yourself or even with a friend and you're just really not sure of the terrain and everything, a campground is a fine place to start. Here are the things that you will not find. You won't find isolation. You won't necessarily find peace and quiet. And you won't find yourself surrounded by nothing but the sounds of creaks and crawly things in the night. What will you find? Oh man, you will find that the people that go to campgrounds are the nicest people on the entire planet. I remember this from when I was a little girl. And again, doing my research, this is a thing I saw over and over and over. You will find yourself as part of a little temporary overnight community of people that will help you. If you needed some help, you could probably just run next door to the next site and somebody would help you. You will find families, you'll find dogs, you'll find just people coming together who really love the outdoors. But there is this thing about camping at a campground that I kind of want to mention and see if you understand what I'm talking about. Camping in a campground is this really interesting combination of two things. So you have all of the trademarks of your outdoors. You got the smell of the pine trees and the smell of the campfires. And, you know, you just feel like a little bit you're getting in touch with your inner outdoor person, which is super cool. But you have all the civility and the rules of being in a small village. And so you have to kind of marry those two things. So the way to do that is to understand the etiquette that you really need to follow. It kind of starts with your campsite and your arrival at the campsite. Now, when you make your booking, whether it's through a state park website or the KOA website or anyone else, they're going to give you a check-in time and a check-out time. You want to really honor that. Don't show up an hour and a half early thinking that you're going to be able to jump in there. maybe you can, but it's, first of all, it's a little inconsiderate. Second of all, the people that are there before, they're like focused, they're enjoying the rest of their breakfast, they're trying to pack up their stuff. So wait, give them the chance to bring their own camp experience to a closure before you show up and start yours. If you happen to arrive at night, come in quietly and come in with your headlights turned down low so you're not waking up people and shining your lights in the windows of their tents or their RVs. It's just the nice thing to do. When it comes to your campsite, you want to respect your site. Now, it might be small. You might be side to side with two other RVs. I don't know what you're going to take. For me, I was always a tent person. I never had an RV, but that is still your little acre for the evening, however big it is. You need to respect that site. It's yours for the evening, but only for the evening. You're a guest in this spot. So do me a favor, don't dig any trenches. Please don't nail anything into the trees. You're just borrowing the place. If you're lucky enough to have your site on some water, you know, a little stream going by, that's really fantastic. But you know, you're not really in the middle of nowhere. There's no need to spit your toothpaste into it. Please don't wash your dishes in it. And whatever you do, don't drink that water. And this is kind of thing I was talking about earlier, like you're camping, you're feeling like you're outdoors. And I don't know about you, for me, it all feels fresh and clean, but that water is not. And you do not want to spend the next 3 days finding out whether or not you have Giardia. So enjoy the noise of it. Enjoy the smell of that fresh water. Leave it alone. So speaking of water, I do want to bring up something that I actually saw on like 5 different websites, and that's washing dishes. I did not know this. When I camped, I was a little girl. I wasn't doing the dishes. And we actually probably used a lot of paper plates. Not great for the environment, but it was 1978. You are not supposed to wash dishes in the bathhouse. Well, ooh, that kind of makes total sense to me. And you're not supposed to wash your dishes at the spigots, you know, the taps where the water is. This also totally makes sense to me. And you may not realize it, but those little food particles that you rinse off your plate, they sit there and they attract bees and bugs and they make a mess. Campgrounds often will have a designated spot for washing your dishes. Just go find out where it is and take care of it that way. Again, that falls into the category of being a good neighbor. So speaking of being a good neighbor, yes, we're in the outdoors, and yes, we want the freedom, the free to be you and me, is that what the song says? But you are elbow to elbow with other people, often with families. So think about what you're doing and how it affects others. Are you a smoker? If you're a smoker, maybe consider walking down the way to a field or something where you're away from people and your smoke won't bug them. Are you drinking around your campfire late at night? Keep the noise down. You know, remember there's families around you and kids. So, and I have to say it because with Trail Dames, this is something that we always talk about. But, you know, if you're a bunch of adults standing around or sitting around the campfire, watch your language, watch your stories, keep everything on the PG side. We can save all that other stuff from when we truly are out in the wilderness. The moms and dads around you will really appreciate it. We were talking about site etiquette. You know, this is another thing that I don't think most of us as adults would do. But if you're camping with your kids, you want to make sure they know to do. Don't cut through other people's sites. Again, that's their little spot for the evening or for the 2 days. So you want to be respectful of that. Quiet hours. Now, this is something I'm not very good at. Another reason I don't hang out at campgrounds very much. But quiet hours are pretty much universal. They're usually 10 to 6. Some may be 9 to 6, 9 to 7. Respect them. People do try to get some peace and quiet when they go camping. And you would be shocked at how well the sound travels at night in the woods. So respect those quiet hours. And oh, lordy, 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 please just say no to generators. If you're in a Winnebago or whatever they're called, pay the extra money for a site. Plug it in, go with the electricity. There is just nothing worse than being at a campsite and hearing that roar of a generator all night long because your neighbors want to do whatever, I don't know, watch a movie, whatever they want to do. Just say no. my personal rule, like I said, I haven't done a lot of camping as an adult, and especially in the last 10 or 20 years, but I've done a shocking amount of driving through campgrounds, headed to trailheads, or else going to pick up my friends when they're camping. And I want to just say a quick word about driving through a campground. You're not in Kansas anymore. This is not your general, normal city living. These people, it's like a 1952 suburb. They will walk down the middle of the street. Children will ride their bikes everywhere. And that's the way it's kind of supposed to be. If you're not used to that, keep in mind that you're not used to that. More than anything, I just want to say, drive slowly. Be careful. Watch for those kids. They are riding their bikes everywhere. And for me, that is like the most important thing that you can do to be respectful. You know, don't make people jump out of your way when you're driving down the road. So one of the best things about camping in general, and especially in a campground, because we don't do this usually when we're backpacking, is having that campfire. You got to admit, it's the best. So there are some rules that you want to follow. The first being, don't bring your own firewood. And this is another thing that I don't remember so much from when I was a kid, but I see this everywhere now. Different areas have different insects. They have different diseases that have been introduced to the tree population. If you're traveling and you're carrying your own firewood, you could spread that. So it's not good. Most campgrounds sell firewood. Just get it from them. And think of it as another way you can support the campground. Most of these campgrounds are small mom and pop operations or small businesses. So buy your firewood from them. Never, ever, ever, ever take wood from living trees. You know, that whole leave no trace thing that we talk about a lot, it still really applies, maybe even more so in a campground where you're there with 200 of your closest friends. But that wood thing, not taking wood from a living tree, taking care of your campfire, that's a really big one. And speaking of that fire, put it out when you go to bed. You know, that thing I was talking about earlier, we have this strange mixture of the freedom of the outdoors, but being also like in a little city, that makes it hard sometimes. Like you'll look at that fire and you'll think, oh, that's an established fire ring. There's a fire in it every night. It's just glowing embers. I'm going to bed. It could still really cause damage. It could still be a problem. Put your fire out. So speaking of putting things up. So, you know, one of the things about my podcast, I'm glad you listen, but I hope you don't ever look up to me as being like the perfect camper hiker. Because if I haven't told you before, I so am not. And this is a really great example. Food. Now, I'm going to tell you, don't leave your food out at night. And again, you might be sitting there going, there's a lot of people around. I don't really think it's going to attract animals. It will. Not only that, don't do what I have done in the past. Don't think that a click shut ice chest is safe. Let me tell you, those critters are smart. I'm embarrassed to say the one time that I camped with the Trail Dames 14 years ago, I had hot dogs. It was before I went back to being a vegetarian, and I had hot dogs, and that's all I had. And I had them in an ice chest, and it had like these really strong little latches. And I was sleeping in my car because I was too lazy to deal with the tent. I did mention I'm not a very good camper, right? But anyway, I woke up the next morning. And my ice chest was open and there was nothing in it. And about 100 feet down the road, I found a little hot dog wrapper. And I was like, and I, first of all, I was really embarrassed, a little horrified. I was supposed to be leading these women and, you know, be a good example. But I also got tickled at myself for thinking that I was smarter than the wildlife, because I certainly wasn't. I promise you, they will get into your ice chests, put your food in your car, or if you're in a RV, bring it in at night. So last but not least, keep that site clean. When you leave the next day, you want to leave it just like you found it, if not cleaner. Please don't leave trash for your neighbors to find. Do not put trash in your fire ring. You'd be shocked at what does not burn. A couple of things that I found in my research that was not anything I ever had to deal with, but it's totally worth mentioning. They talked about if you're going in an RV of some kind, know how your sewer connections work. how to use them correctly and what to do if you have problems. You, I'm just saying, tents are looking better and better, but that makes a lot of sense, you know, because you want to be responsible for the equipment you're using. If you're camping with your dogs, keep them on a leash, clean up after them. This is just everyday, logical, being kind to others sense, but it bears saying. So I am going to leave you with one thing. I did find it funny. In all the research, I found one thing that I never did see in 1978. And that is on the KOA national website, they say one of the etiquette things is share the Wi-Fi. Now, I won't lie to you, it would never even occur to me that that was a thing. But it turns out some campgrounds do have Wi-Fi, but that it's, you know, it's limited and there's a whole bunch of you there in one spot trying to use it. So it suggests, you know, maybe this isn't the best time to stream a couple of movies in a row. Instead, get outside your camper, enjoy the outdoors, go on a hike, and have fun while you're camping. Now, I hope that taught you some things about camping. If you've never been, oh, totally go. If you need some friends, come join us on the Trail Dames Facebook page. Put a call out and say, I live so-and-so and I want to go camping. Someone go with me. And 9 times out of 10, someone will jump to the chance. Maybe someday I'll see you at a campground. I'll probably be picking up a hiker or headed for the trailhead because, like I told you, I'm just not very good at that. But I do love the idea. And I hope that all of you are more inspired now to get out and do it yourselves. And I just want to say thanks again. Thanks for listening to the Trail Dames podcast. And if you have any ideas for Lanyaps that you would like to see us cover, give me a holler. Shoot me an email at info@traildames.com and we'll be sure to do it. Thanks again. My name is Anna Huthmaker. All my friends call me Mudbutt. And you've been listening to a Lanyap episode of the Trail Dames podcast.